super excited to do this, and really thank you for being here and for your patience while we got this product ready for you. So, just to give you an introduction to me, for those of you who may not have been here last year, I am the VP of Marketing, and I'm based out of the Denver office. We've got an incredible marketing team out of Denver. We're growing, and now with the addition of Tom out of Seattle, we're even stronger. So a little bit about my background. I'm a marketing and sales professional, and I actually started off in sales with Coca-Cola. Some of you have probably heard of that company. And I ran one of the largest and most profitable territories in California, and actually it was the largest in the nation, and was the top salesperson throughout my entire time at Coca-Cola. And back in the day at Coca-Cola, they used to run these major sales contests, and I won one, and I actually went to the other Atlantis hotel. I took my entire family there, so that's the only other time I stayed at the Atlantis Caribbean. After Coca-Cola, I went into marketing, and I worked for a large cashback website in the United States called Shop at Home, one of our biggest competitors. So I'm very familiar with the cashback industry, and I've been in it for quite some time. Like so many others on our management team, I'm also an entrepreneur. I started my first and only company, UC Miles, and what that company did was manage all of your loyalty points, everything from frequent flyer points to retail points, in one central dashboard. And we showed you ways to use those miles and points to get free travel or more. We sold that company at the end of 2013, and about 6 months later, I came on board DubLi, and I haven't looked back.
Perhaps you're going to spend it skydiving over the pond. so powerful about our product. My job, on the other hand, is to work with our incredible product team, our sales team, and all the other people in our offices, the builders of the product, to create an incredible customer experience on the website. And for the first time today, we are unveiling all of this to a select group of people. So, Nick and Kurt talked a little bit about some of the concepts that we're going to be launching on the new website. I'm going to dive into some of the larger concepts and really explain what they mean for the network and what they mean for our customers on DubLi. Wow, these guys look like they're having way more fun than I do. They just look like they're happy. Now, how many of us in the audience have played a video game? I bet most of us have played at least one video game in our lives. Many of us probably played more video games than we're willing to admit, right? One of the more popular video games in the last decade is World of Warcraft. World of Warcraft has amassed $8.4 billion in revenue since 2004. Gamification and the rewards component works. Rewards could mean anything. Points, badges, status. Any incentive a company uses to motivate you as their customer to complete an action. But rewards don't necessarily need to take place in a video console. Companies like DubLi can use gamification and game mechanics in a non-gaming environment. Let's take a look at a couple of examples. Frequent flyer programs are probably the oldest form of gamification. These are the loyalty programs that the airlines started to reward their most valuable customers. I bet everybody in this room belongs to at least one loyalty program, right? Whether it be travel or retail or even grocery. In the United States alone, the average household belongs to 29 loyalty programs. That seems a bit ridiculous, but it's true. You know, why do we do this? We do it because we are addicted to earning points and getting status. What about my Starbucks rewards? Oh, I know. I love this. I love this app. My Starbucks rewards is one of the most successful examples of gamification. Why? Because Starbucks rewards their users with a tangible benefit. Free coffee. Who doesn't love free coffee, right? Starbucks has been extremely successful. This app, this mobile app, gets over 6 million transactions per week and is responsible for 15% of Starbucks sales. Gamification done correctly has the ability to engage audiences on an emotional level and keep them coming back for more. DubLi is embedding gamification into our core product. And just like Starbucks, the reward is the product. We reward our users with extra cash back for completing actions on the website. It's that easy and it's that fun. What does this mean for you? So we know that gamification boosts engagement. It makes the website and platform sticky and almost addictive. What this means is users spend more time on the platform and they make more purchases. For you guys, that means more commissions. So it's a great thing. Let's talk a little bit about how gamification actually works on DubLi. I'm going to use our friend the DubBot as an example. When the DubBot joins DubLi for the first time, he automatically gets into a premium membership. And it's a trial for 3 months. The premium membership, like Kurt mentioned, gives him double cash back, that of the basic membership. So then when he gets to the end of his trial period, DubLi starts sending him communications that are customized and relevant that start offering opportunities for him to earn extra cash back in order to stay at that premium level. The DubBot is super excited now. DubLi has tons purchases, referring your friends, liking the platform on social, social sharing on the website, installing our mobile app or our browser extension. There's tons of ways that are fun to gamify the process and encourage our users to do more on the website. And then they get extra cash back, double cash back. So we've looked a little at how DubLi is using gamification to help our customers earn more cash back and increase their engagement on the site. Let's now talk a little bit about how personalization can help our customers save time by simply giving them what they want. So I'm sure all of us can agree that the internet has become very noisy. There is tons and tons of content out there. So much, in fact, that people oftentimes have trouble finding what they want. And for that reason, customers become much more selective in which companies they work with and which companies earn their business. According to a statistic from January, actually 3/4 of internet customers get frustrated with companies when their content doesn't speak to their interests. I know I do. I don't want to see content about diapers because I don't have a child. But, you know, a pair of new tennis shoes or sneakers, I'm interested. You've got my attention now. Personalization is key to solving this problem. So let's look at how a couple of other companies are handling personalization, and then we'll go into how DubLi is doing it. So Coca-Cola, the company that I used to work for, Coca-Cola, about 2 years ago, launched a campaign called Share a Coke, where they replaced their iconic Coca-Cola logo with the names of their customers. It sounds kind of goofy. I know Michael thinks it's goofy. But it worked. And it worked so well that Coca-Cola ended up rolling it out into 50 different countries. And it ended up growing their traffic on Facebook alone by more than 780%. People were just in love with the idea of personalizing their experience with Coke and sharing a Coke with their friends that have their name on it. And Coca-Cola did a great job of blending localization with personalization because every country got their own names, depending on the most, you know, popular names in that country. Let's now look at Amazon. Amazon has been a pioneer in mining data to deliver customized, personalized experiences to their consumers. This is a picture of my homepage compared to one of my friends' homepages. They are very, very different. Why? Because Amazon has used all of the data they know about me and my past purchases to deliver a totally unique experience for me. This is advertising, you guys, but it doesn't look like advertising because they're showing me what I want. And the reason they're doing this is because I am going to make a purchase, and they're going to make more money. Now, look, I've got to mention, Amazon is great, but they're missing a couple of things. And I'm sure we're all thinking the same thing right now. When I go to Amazon, I've got to shop at Amazon. I can't shop at any of the other stores that I love. I can't shop at Priceline. I can't shop at Nordstrom's or Walmart or Overstock. That is a big problem. Second problem, Amazon doesn't give me cash back. Game over. I'm shopping at DubLi. All right, so let's look a little bit at how personalization works on DubLi. And now we're going to use myself as an example. I would like to consider myself a bit of an athlete, a bit of an outdoorsy person. I run marathons. At least I used to before I started working at DubLi. That's the truth. I haven't done one since. I climb mountains. I snowboard in the winter. I love to lift weights. All of these habits and hobbies are really influencing my purchase decisions. For instance, I just bought a new pair of trail running shoes because mine worn out. And I just got a great deal on DubLi on a pair of trekking poles. deliver me unique, customized offers, coupons, merchant deals, offers they think I might like because of my interests and hobbies. So here's a page of mine that might be delivered by DubLi. Where does DubLi get all of this data? Great question. DubLi has access to lots of data about our users, and you can break it out into three major buckets. The first bucket is offline data that we get via our mobile app, shopping habits that people do online. The second bucket of data is the search and shopping behavior we get from our browser usage. The third bucket of data is all of the rich data we collect on our own website when they are shopping and searching and favoriting stores and all of these things you see up here, all of the content that they engage with. Our platform is so intelligent and built to take all of this in and to disseminate it into a completely customized, unique experience for all of you in this room. Nothing will be the same. How awesome is that? It doesn't stop with the website. All of our communications to our customers will be very, very personalized. From email, to mobile, to social. Nick and Kirk are going to get back up here and talk about mobile, so I'm going to focus on email for now. Our email program is going to completely change with the launch of our new site. We also have a ton of email campaigns that are planned to upgrade our customers into the VIP lounge, which might be Nick. Yeah! I don't want to steal the thunder for the new VIP lounge, so I'm going to leave it there. We've got lots of plans. Our daily emails will contain lots and lots of content for events. And events are both global and local, and they give our users reasons to shop, which earn you more commissions. Let me give you an example. The entire year of 2014 at DubLi, we launched 29 events in all of our markets. In Q4 of 2015 alone, DubLi will be launching 197 events worldwide. These events are global and local. We have amassed a local team of market representatives from all over the world, and they work with our marketing team to curate all of those local events in every single region so that our customers can have personal experiences with events that they actually care about. Events like Diwali in India or Children's Day in Brazil. All of these events are going to take place in email and on the website and the platform. So we've talked about how we are personalizing the experience on the website, which is so important to not only create a better experience for our customers, but also create more purchases. It's also important for companies of our size to create incentives for our existing consumers to invite their friends into the platform. So DubLi is launching with two brand new, unique customer referral programs. I'm going to go over both of them right now. So the first program is actually built on the Invite a Friend platform that pays a person to refer their friends to the website with one very unique twist. Let me give you an example. So let's say I invite Alex onto DubLi. As soon as I invite Alex onto the website, I get a boost. And we all remember, this is gamification. This helps me earn double cash back at the premium level. All I got to do is invite Alex to the website. Then, when Alex joins and makes his first purchase, I get paid. DubLi just pays me. $5. So we are actually rewarding our customers twice just for referring their friends to the site. This program is open to any of our customers on the website, and anybody can join. spread this program. Customers can promote it to their friends through email, through social, through any of these personalized links, and they can access all of their data and the metrics of how they're doing right within the website. The second program is called DubLi Elite, and it's a program that was designed for a different type of customer. And these are our customers who are that have a verifiable source of leads. They could be a blogger, they could be a media person, they could be an ambassador. This program is an application program. You need to apply to get in, and the marketing team actually looks into every single application before approving our ambassadors. It gets really fun when you get into the DubLi Elite program because it's not like anything else that's out there. The DubLi Elite Ambassador Program pays our elites 20% of the lifetime commissions of all of the purchases their referrals make. So in comparison to some of the other referral programs that are out there, like Amazon's, Amazon only pays you one time per purchase. So if you're a blogger, you have to continue sending that same person back to Amazon in order to continue to get paid. This is a huge differentiator, and this is why we are going to steal all of Amazon's business, not you. So, we are getting very close to launching this new website. And one of the jobs of marketing is to make sure that after this website launches, that each and every one of you in this room stands out. We want to make sure that you have enough marketing material and content so that you can sell and promote all of the wonderful features and functionality that we've discussed today. So we are going to be supplying you with a huge amount of marketing material that you can share with your networks. Everything from personalized landing pages for different demographics to all of the different content for events throughout the world to content that will help you sell up and upgrade the VIP lounge and the mobile app. How fun is that going to be? The browser extension. We have got a lot of things that are coming down the pike as well for your back office. We can't talk about everything today because if we tell you everything today, we'll have no surprise. Global and localized rich blog content. How awesome is that? And then our personalization engine will kick in. So you will only get the type of content that you know you want to read. Now, we all know that Facebook is still, by far, the largest social platform out there. So because it's so important, I want to share a story with you to help you understand some of the decisions Facebook has made in the last year. At the beginning of 2014, Facebook took a look at their business and they said, wow, you know, this is getting noisy. People's news feeds are getting cluttered with content that we don't know if they really want. So Facebook drew a hard line and decided that they were not going to necessarily show all of the content that companies put out there for the people who have liked our page. So what this now means is that DubLi's followers on Facebook aren't necessarily seeing all of the content that we're posting each day. In fact, sources vary, but some folks say that, you know, Facebook is only showing about 10 to 15% of our content to the people that follow us on Facebook. And experts say that every single social platform is going to follow suit, and soon they're all going to be doing this. This is kind of a bummer, you know, as a company. But guess what? We know how to make this work for us. Facebook shows content that gets social engagement. The more content is liked and shared, the higher it climbs in the Facebook algorithm and the more people it goes out to. So, one thing we have are a lot of people in this room. So if we all can start liking our social platforms, you've got to be following us on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram and all of these. so I'm doing that tomorrow night. And then we give the winner $300 from hotels.com. So once again, if you're not following us on our social profiles, please follow us today. And now you understand why it's also super important for you to engage with a brand. Well, I think I'm done, guys. Product, but it's really exciting, and it's just yet another example of some of the things